In this video, I'll describe how purine and pyrimidine deoxynucleotides are derived from ribonucleotides, and I'll talk about regulation of this process. The enzyme ribonucleotide reductase is responsible for reducing ribonucleotides to deoxyribonucleotides by removing the oxygen on the 2' carbon of the sugar. The enzyme acts on ribonucleotides in the diphosphate form only, so that means that CTP must first be dephosphorylated to CDP before it can be reduced. I won't go into details about the mechanism, but the ultimate source of electrons for the process is NADPH. After the deoxynucleotide diphosphates are synthesized, they are phosphorylated to the triphosphate form. Ribonucleotide reductase is quite a fascinating enzyme in its regulation. There are different classes in the enzyme family, but the one we're going to look at contains two alpha subunits and two beta subunits in its active form. The alpha subunits contain the active sites, while the beta subunits contain a metal binding site that is required for the reaction to take place. Notably, the alpha subunits also have two regulatory sites. One is called the activity site, and one is called the specificity site. As their names suggest, binding of nucleotides at the activity site regulates whether the enzyme is active or not, and binding of nucleotides at the specificity site regulates which ribonucleotides the enzyme uses as its substrates. This chart summarizes how the enzyme is regulated. When ATP binds to the activity site, the enzyme is active. Initially, the enzyme will favor reduction of pyrimidines to make DCDP and DUDP. These can be converted to DTTP, as I'll describe in a minute. As the DTTP concentration increases, it will bind to the specificity site, at which point further reduction of pyrimidine nucleotides is inhibited, and instead the active site prefers to bind GDP, which is converted to DGDP, and then phosphorylated to give DGTP. As the DGTP concentration increases, it will displace DTTP from the specificity site. And when DGTP is bound, the active site will preferentially reduce ADP to deoxy-ADP. Then, when deoxy-ATP accumulates, it will displace ATP from the activity site and inhibit the enzyme. Thus, all four deoxynucleotides are synthesized in a controlled way that keeps their concentrations in balance for DNA synthesis. Now we need to return to deoxythymine triphosphate. Since TDP does not exist in cells, how is this pyrimidine synthesized? Deoxy-TDP is made from the other two pyrimidine deoxynucleotides. When DUDP is made, the nonspecific nucleotide kinase in cells will phosphorylate it to DUTP. This is a problem because DNA polymerase does not distinguish between DUTP and DTTP. So, to prevent uracil from being incorporated into DNA, the DUTP is quickly dephosphorylated to DUMP. This nucleotide can be methylated to make DTMP, which is then phosphorylated to give DTTP. It seems kind of awkward to dephosphorylate the nucleotide and then have to rephosphorylate it, but I think this is the price of having a non-specific nucleotide kinase available in the cell. In the second pathway to make thymine deoxynucleotides, DCDP is dephosphorylated to DCMP and then converted to DUMP. So I've now explained how all the nucleotides in RNA and DNA are synthesized. This diagram summarizes the pathways of nucleotide synthesis. On the exam, you are responsible for what's on this slide, plus you should understand the role of PRPP and the overall strategies for how the purine and pyrimidine bases are made. But don't worry about the details of chemical reactions of the pathways. Regulation of the pathways is fairly straightforward. Nucleotide products inhibit their own synthesis. ATP activates pyrimidine synthesis and reduction of ribonucleotides, and DATP inhibits synthesis of deoxyribonucleotides. So that's it for nucleotide synthesis. In the next video, I'll give a brief summary of how nucleotides are degraded.